What's going on, everybody? Johnny here with a little bit of a video. I want to talk about our first full month cross-listing. What that looked like. Is it right for you? Does it make sense for you? Because I don't think it necessarily makes sense for everybody. If you look at it very simply, it's list all your stuff on multiple platforms. Why wouldn't you do that? But there's a lot to it. We're going to talk a little bit. I know people don't love what sold videos, but I think it's important to chat a little bit about what's selling on these platforms. I don't know about you guys, but to me, eBay is for everything. Poshmark is for clothes. Mercari's for hard goods and toys. And Depop's for vintage. So is that true since we've been cross-listing? Let's take a look and talk a little bit more. We signed up for Vendu on January 14th, so our first month ended on February 14th, but February really is our first full month where we can just compare January numbers to February numbers, and it was interesting, eye-opening. Some things were awesome, some things were disappointing. Some of it's our fault, there's costs into it. There's a lot to it. Starting off with the pros, one of the first pros is what it has done to our Depop sales. Yes, Depop has popped off. Our best month ever was last June, I think. We did about $180. For reference, last month in January, we did about $82, and we are currently $678 in net sales. So Depop has taken off, almost quadrupled our best month ever. And we're selling things like this. This old Oakland Raiders sweatshirt. It's even got some bleach stains on it, but it sold in days. Also, summer is coming. Our other Depop sale from this weekend, these surf style shorts, even with the Daytona Beach on it, those spring breakers getting ready, but these sold for $32.99. Those two sales right there are typically our month on Depop in the past, but since we have been cross-listing, we have been throwing everything on everything, as long as it's allowed, right? Can't go over 10 pounds on Poshmark, can't sell golf clubs on Poshmark, things like that. So if the website, if the platform allows it, we're just listing it and seeing what happens. Why not? But because of that, it's taking a little bit longer to get everything up and running. And one of the areas where this is really hurting is our Poshmark. To give you an idea, in January, we did almost $1,700 in net sales. And as of February 27th, we're at just over $800. Which is half of what we did last month. And last month is kind of in line with what we typically do on Poshmark. We haven't quite cracked that Poshmark code, but to cut our Poshmark sales in half, terrible. Thankfully, Depop has picked up. Thankfully, we've come back to Mercari, so it's kind of been a wash. But if you're doing a cross-listing, you want to be up, not just move the money around. Our only sale on Depop is this Farm Rio dress that we actually sold on eBay a couple weeks back, but unfortunately it didn't fit the buyer, so they sent it back to us, and thankfully it will find a home on Poshmark. Poshmark does not allow returns for fit, and this doesn't have any flaws to it, so this will go to its permanent home via Poshmark. But that was it, our only Poshmark sale. We got to get that going. Brings me to one of the cons. It's time consuming. It's not just list it, click, 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 and it's on all the other platforms. You have to select the categories and things like that because each website, each platform does shipping different. It does its categories different, and it doesn't always cleanly just select all the proper categories. So it is time consuming. We have 100 listings on eBay, so bringing that over one by one on Posh is going to take time, and you have to do the one by one because you need them all to read each other, because the reason we did cross-listing and chose Vendu was because we needed that auto cross-listing. We had actually fallen to below standard because we were double selling stuff that we just didn't have that was already gone that we had forgotten to take down on the other platform. So something to consider is that there's some time with getting yourself set up if you have a well-established store, and by that I mean a lot of listings. This brand we had not found out in the wild in a while. Frizz was at her home in Indianapolis visiting family, got to do some thrifting there, and she rediscovered Ibex. It had been so long since we had found it, and she found not one, not two, but three different Ibex pieces. And these two sold in a bundle on Macari for $59.
Hey everybody, Johnny real quick, breaking in. If you have not yet subscribed to the channel and you've watched a couple of our videos, we would love to have you join our journey. And also be sure to like and comment as well. We love being able to interact with you. And a question for you, do you use a cross-listing platform? Why not? Which one do you use? Pros, cons? Does it make sense for your business? Really, really curious to know.
When we first started reselling in January of 2022, we signed up for eBay, Poshmark, and then Mercari, I think in like March or April, as we kind of started to get our bearings a little bit. We had one sale for $29. And then that was it. Absolute crickets on Mercari. So we stopped and we never had any sales again on Mercari until we started to cross list. And if you're going to cross list, why not just throw it out there everywhere? So last month in February, we had one or two sales, really tiny, for like $18. So still not our best month. But now here in February that we've had a full month of reselling on Mercari, we've done about $300 in net sales, which is 10 times our best month that we've ever had. So it pays to get it out there. But I will say, now we're selling on eBay, we're selling on Poshmark, we're selling on Mercari, we're selling on Depop, we do whatnot shows. That's a lot of platforms, and that might not make sense for you. It is four or five different platforms with four or five different rules to how they operate, to four and five different ways to print labels. It can be a lot and it can be overwhelming. I love getting sales anywhere. That's the whole point of why we do this. But when I go to ship and I go to print labels and I've got to generate all the eBays and I've got to generate Posh and then Mercari and then Depop, it is a lot. And you have to decide whether or not that makes sense for your business and for you. We have this vintage Nike windbreaker going out on Mercari as well. Look at that tag. You can always just Google and say show Nike tags by decades and you can find out when that tag is from, but that's pretty cool. And by the luck of the Irish, I found these Shamrock Vans.
Damn,
yeah, I probably Daniel. Would not have picked these up if it wasn't going to be St. Patrick's Day in a couple weeks now. So listed these. These sold on Mercari for $31. Happy to get them out, and hopefully whoever has bought these will rock these to celebrate St. Patrick's Day.
One of the other things that you have to consider are the supplies you use. These shoes are going out ground advantage. We still ship all of our shoes priority. So that way, like this, we can use a priority box. But now with these being ground advantage, I've got to find a box to put these in. Not really a big deal, but it's just something else to consider.
Last thing selling on Mercari is this Patagonia shirt. Patagonia, almost always a good idea. This is new. It's on, not new, pre-worn, but new how old it is. It's on the screen printed tag. Patagonia, usually always a good idea. I wouldn't pay up for something like this, as I think it sold for like $12, but definitely something to consider. And those are the types of things that sell on Mercari. So no toys, no hard goods. While we get to the eBay sales, just kind of recap some of the pros. It allows you to expand your business when you're talking about cross-listing. We have brought Depop back from the dead. We are using Mercari, which we really never used before. And it also allows you to grow your business, right? You're selling on more platforms, so it gives you an opportunity to have more sales and buy more things and just kind of have more fun with all of this reselling. And then the auto detect, the real reason we got into this, and a month and a half in, we are back to top rated seller on eBay. So we have gone from jail a couple months ago back to being a top rated seller. And that's because we have been able to manage our business a lot better. No more double sales, no more cancels. We've learned a lot in the last couple months, especially since we've been in eBay jail, but definitely some reasons to consider a cross-listing platform. Just picked up a couple things in Indianapolis that have sold just immediately. Those Ibex shirts that she picked up that sold on Macari. She also picked up another Ibex shirt, new with tag, that sold on eBay. But the star of the show is definitely this Scotty vest. 2XLT, the T means tall, but this is a carrying jacket, a concealed carrying jacket. It's got spots for the permits. It even will take off the sleeves if you want to make it into a vest. She paid $7 or $8 for this. It sold for $175 plus shipping in a day or two. An absolute beast of a find, but Scotty vests, a brand I was not really familiar with, but I'm going to be keeping an eye out for now.
Now that the weather's starting to warm up, another good brand that sells pretty well for us is Chubbies, although this like sleep romper thing took a little while to sell, but keep Chubbies in your radar.
A fun sale, but not something you necessarily want to pick up. We sold this 1984 Olympic duffel bag. It's a vintage Levi bag. Olympic stuff. You want it to be cool, and sometimes it is cool, but it sits, it is slow moving. So always comp and look up Olympic stuff before you just grab it. You see the USA, you see the rings, especially it's old, you'll see a lot of stuff from Lake Placid in 1980 and stuff like that, and you just want to get it because it's cool. And then you have it forever. This bag sat around for a very, very long time. Happy to see it go because it is cool, but just be prepared. A lot of Olympic stuff will just sit. Also, because I know everybody doesn't love what sold videos, even though I think you can learn a lot from what sold, I'm going to pop up some other sales that happened so that way we don't have to talk about all of them. In the bread and butter world, Eileen Fisher, one of Frizzy's favorite brands. Come on, Eileen, an old standby. Doesn't sell for as much as it used to, although some pieces do. But usually when she finds Eileen Fisher, she'll pick it up. She won't pay up for it, but if she sees it, she'll at least consider it. And at the bins, as long as it's in good shape, it's coming home with us. This is going down as our sale of the week. And keep in mind, sale of the week does not necessarily mean the best sale, because that's that Scotty jacket. But sometimes it's just something you're excited to sell, you're excited about, or maybe you're just excited to know that you don't own it anymore. And that is this American Eagle crop top blouse shirt. I don't even know what you call it, but this shirt was one of the first purchases we made when we started reselling a little over 2 years ago. We were like, American Eagle floral, it's cute, buy it. Yes, we posted it. It has been listed for 2+ years. And one of the things that I've done with old inventory to try to get it to move is I have adopted a free shipping rule. If it is old, actually, if it's very low cost, right? If you're selling something for $6, you don't want to have plus $6 shipping on it. So you do it for like $11.99 free shipping, and it kind of all works out. So that is what I did here. This sold with free shipping just to try to make it a little bit more enticing. Hopefully it fits and it doesn't get returned back, because it is really cute, and spring again, summer coming. But we are happy to see this go. This American Eagle top is our sale of the week, our see you later of the week. So the cons for us have definitely been the time it has taken to get everything up and running, because we're not even up and running yet and it's been 6 weeks. It takes a minute or two to get every posting up. And when you're talking about 1,200 listings and 1,200, 2,400 minutes, it's a very, very long time. And I don't think we realized how long it would take to get our store back up. When we took everything down on Poshmark, I thought a long weekend with some hard work and it would be back up, and it's just not the case. Life happens, the business continues to happen, so you really have to stay disciplined to get it up and running. Also, we paid $300 for a computer so that way we could always leave the screen up for the auto delisting. We have a laptop that we do, you know, 95% of our business on. But when with a laptop, you close the lid, you kind of toss it. You don't really think about needing to leave it up at all time. And your computer has to be continuously running for the auto detect to kick in. Other than that, you're going to resell. I don't know. To us, it just didn't make sense. So we also have that invested. So we're $300 in on a computer. We are $70 in for the cost of the using the platform. And then last month, it was 40% off, so whatever that is, like $45. So we're almost $500 invested into Crosslisting, and we're kind of flat at this point. However, I do think long-term, it'll totally be worth it. It's so much work that they kind of have you a little bit, because you're not going to do all this and cross over 1,200 items and then go, nah, I'm not going to use it. It's going to be months for us to get up and running back to 100%. So just keep in mind, there's some time, there's commitment. I'm not saying go out and get a computer. That's just how our brain worked and what made sense for us. Also, there's been some glitches where we haven't been able to post on Mercari, or eBay's had some glitches that kind of impact the cross-listing part. So there's also that. It's not perfect. It's pretty darn good, but it is not perfect. And then, I mean, like I said before, all those different rules, shipping rules and price rules, and things have to be whole dollars and percentages. When you're using a lot of different platforms, you've got a lot of balls in the air. So it's something to consider if that makes sense. If it's just a fun kind of side hobby, you know, like my mom, she sells a couple things here or there. She's not going to, one, spend $70 on a cross-listing platform, and two, she doesn't want to get overwhelmed by, okay, it's sold on Posh, so as long as it's under 5 pounds or whatever, it's too much. So you really have to decide where you're at in your business and where you want your business to go, if the cross-listing platforms are even worth it.
Everything has finally been packed up. I am going to the post office, but I wish just one thing. I love this Hulkin bag. I bought this Hulkin bag for Frizz, but since I tend to go to the post office, I wish I picked a different color. But not sponsored. The wheels on this thing are amazing. I wish I got the midnight blue, but it came out after I ordered this one.
The bowling bag, the Hulkin bag. It's all you need.
So Frizz and I, we do not gatekeep at all. If you want to know where we thrift or where we go, we will tell you. But I will not share my post office. Marty and the boys are too good. We cannot share it. So there you have it. A quick look at what sold using a cross-listing platform. Curious to see what sells on Mercari and what happens on Depop when you kind of take the training wheels off a little bit. But again, Johnny here. Please comment, like, subscribe, all that good stuff. Let me know what you're thinking about cross-listing. Again, do you use it? Don't you? Does it make sense? Love to hear that back from you. And we will see you guys on the next one. Thank you again so much for making it to the end of this video. If you have not checked out either of these two videos yet, be sure to. Also, comment, like, subscribe. We'll see you soon.